I got an RPG anything. And some shit to work out. Let's see how that goes for him. Dead as a
doornail. Oh, look at him going through the...
I don't want to die before I make my first million.
You're not going to die. I got you, buddy.
I love the invisible... It's like Wonder Woman, except it's an invisible rocket launcher. Oh, well, we got bullets. You can see the rockets, but no launcher.
There's so much blood.
You have more agency and power than the world wants.
Whoa.
To realize it.
Easy enough.
The entire thing was on mute. Hello, welcome to the stream. Take two on that. Welcome. Hey, hi, hello. Hopefully you enjoyed the highlights if you saw it. That was from my highlights for Saints Row. This is now like 5 minutes since then. So we played SmackDown Here Comes the Pain, which is like 2 years old. We played SmackDown versus Raw, and now let's go with SmackDown Shut Your Mouth. I don't know who I want to play here, so that's the big thing that we're going to figure out first and foremost. We're not going to do the draft because that is a whole long process that I don't want to do. And there's some that we're just not going to play and play as. We can't play as Christian because we did that with SmackDown versus Raw. We can't play as Edge because we did that in Here Comes the Pain. And we're not going to play as him because of, if you know wrestling, you know why. And I try not to, I want to get like the full experience. I'm very, very proficient in this game. I know exactly what we want, what we don't want. Actually, speaking of being proficient, let me change difficulty real quick. Because I remember last time I played, I did so good on it. Not kidding. I'm gonna drop the difficulty because actually let's do it like an exhibition match. See how the difficulty is. Let's just get into it this way. Fucking sure. Where's Stacy? We'll also see if camera placement's good. Fucking awesome. The Duchess of Dudleyville. Let's just make sure we're doing this at Raw. Cool. Let's see how the difficulty is. If we get our ass kicked, then awesome. We're just gonna do other stuff. We're gonna change it. It should be at like normal. And we're gonna get. This is probably one of the copyrights, I guess. Now, the Fink introductions is one of the reasons why I like this game over Here Comes the Pain, is because there's voice acting. You get the Fink on introductions. You get JR and King on ring announcing. So it's definitely my preferred game as a kid. Plus, it was 2-year season modes instead of just the one. Okay. Alright, let's do this. Alright. I forgot. Alright, well, let's hope we don't get freaking banned for this. Okay, so the only thing that's being covered right now, and I know it'll change for tag matches, is going to be just the timer, which I don't remember being present in season mode. Okay, so we might be okay here. I want to turn up. A little practice match to get back into it.
No, I can't believe it. There's the kick out.
You can see under that. Yeah, if you see the lights and stuff, I have the
brakes.
But we're gonna see how quickly we can get through. Oh my god.
Look at his eyes. They're bugging out.
First couple months this season. So in this game there's no weight detection. It's very much still in kind of the SmackDown 2 era style play, where there's no weight detection, there's no like collar and elbow tie up, everything is just kind of pick up and do things. That's why I keep doing the same shit over and over again. There's like 3 sets of moves, so if you pick them up, you can give them a kick in the gut, and then that's a kind of a different move. Different move set.
Wow, this is my new favorite defense, JR.
Yes. Alright, let's get a. God, yeah, I really wish the. Dragon around. Oh my god!
Wow.
Didn't know she was tech. There's no. There is no, bars for kick out or for submission, as you just saw. Everything's kind of like butt mashy. Let's do another educator. I didn't know she had a tech like that.
Don't hurt the puppies! The puppies are in trouble!
No, they're not. You're talking about Bubba's puppies? Yeah, they are. They're gonna bite in the canvas. Yep. Big bastard. Oh, we get the elbow. Get them across the dick. Nope. Alright. Prop them up here. Oh, yeah, you can spin them. Oh! The kick! And then if you press, I think, L2, you get the winning move. Now, that was the fun thing, is you could press different buttons after winning, and it would give you different stuff. So, sweet. Difficulty's all good. All right, now let's go figure out who we're going to play as. Let's see. We might do a wheel decide. I do like my wheel decides. I kind of want someone who's like mid-card. Eddie actually sounds kind of interesting to play as. We won't really get to play as him much. Farouk would be fun. Trying to think of, I would do the Hurricane, but there was once upon a time where I did get Hurricane to be WWE champion, and it was really fun. I don't want to pick anyone who's a champion or anyone who's too far down on a card. Like Orton would be way too far down right now. Rikishi Banzai. I'd also never play as Austin because you'll find out if we play as Raw. Actually, I don't know. I don't know if I want to do Raw or SmackDown. Regal would be kind of fun. Al Snow, Albert. Billy would be fun. Kidman. Actually, I don't think you know what? Let's be the Booker, man. Let's be Booker. I like Booker T. I haven't done Booker T yet. Booker's seems like it'd be a fun one.
We welcome you here live.
Good evening.
WWE Raw.
Tonight, we will witness the first ever World Wrestling Entertainment Draft. Vince McMahon will represent SmackDown. Ric Flair will represent Raw.
Tonight,
both Mr. Flair and Mr. McMahon will take turns picking superstars from their respective brands. Shut up, guys. The entire roster will be available for selection during the draft. In the interest of time, only 20 picks.
For each show.
All right.
The rest of the 20 superstars will be decided by lottery.
You done, JR? All right. Lottery to the side. Shut up. All right. So we're just going to skip. And just because I want to get to action, we're going to skip the draft. Sorry. But it allows us to edit both brands. So it'll be fun. And I think I want to kind of even this up a little bit. We'll just do a quick edit here because I think we're going to play on SmackDown. Oh God, he's 82. That's fine. But we're just going to do a little bit of nonsense and move him over here. Because I don't want to go. Actually, we get the Steve Austin stuff. We'll keep it. We'll just switch Regal. Because that's what I wanted to do. Regal on 72. Fuck. All right, we'll move Farouk back over to Raw, so that they can have a European title. Some mid card title that they would actually go for. So here are our champions. We got the Undisputed Undertaker as champion. Intercontinental champion is Rob Van Dam. Tag team champions are the Un-Americans, Lance Storm and Christian. European champion, as we just saw, is Bill Regal. Cruiserweight champion is the Hurricane. And Bradshaw, the Rootin' Tootin' Texan, is the Hardcore champion. All right. That's where we're going to start. So this is kind of the roster here. So there's a lot of good on Raw, actually. Alright, but we're the Booker, man. We're gonna be 82 overall. I think you need to be like 85 or something to get 85 or higher to get the title match. So let's see. And we're gonna hear that a lot. We're gonna hear that first 5 seconds a lot. All right, and immediately we're going against the last guy we played, which was Christian. So in the last match there, Kane and RVD, which was a tag at the time, versus Big Show and Jericho. Jericho, but like 10 years. Like, when was Jericho? Anyway, that's it. What's my static? Today is the start. Okay, it's going way too fast for me to actually catch up. So. We promise that bring you that thrill and excitement straight to your television sets. Thanks, JR. Thanks, King. Woo! Hey, Booker, I'm really glad you're on WWE Raw.
Flair,
might move my camera up.
Because
I don't want to get in the way of that. You know, when I was the champ, I had to travel some rough roads back in my day. But at the same time, I was able to accomplish my dreams and the dreams of many fans out there. I believe that you have that same vision. I'm expecting you to do well on Raw, alright? You get the JR word. Okay. Not great, JR. Not great. Bet. Alright, and this is the best part. Let's go backstage and see if anyone is out and about. Oh, this is shop zone. So you see all the stuff we're going to be able to get. Videos that we won't get to watch. Anyway, stuff that's not going to matter too much. It doesn't look like there's anybody on the concourse, so let's start. And we can go anywhere, but I don't really want to take up all that time. First match, Spike Dudley versus Sean Stasiak from Planet Stasiak. And here we go. Versus Christian. Let's get a good view of that entrance here.
Can you dig it, sucker?
This game is so good.
The following contest is scheduled for one ball. On the way to the ring, from Houston, Texas, weighing 251 pounds, Booker T.
Like the graphics, the models look good, the stages look good, the pyro looks like shit. But it's so good. Such a good game. I really feel like this is like an underrated one because I think because of everything that Here Comes the Pain does is what this game does, but it does it better. But this is to me a often forgotten about game. Let's see the Christian. We'll watch them this time. First time they show up, we'll watch them.
From Toronto, Canada.
And then we'll skip through.
Weighing 225 pounds, Christian.
That's another thing too that I like about this game. Look how big that title belt is. That's one of my pet peeves when it comes to wrestling games, is how like incredibly small the titles are for a lot of the people. So I love how big these belts are. The only problem is like, you won't see it for Booker, you won't see it for Christian, but like for Edge and for Jericho, and I even think for Hogan, when they're champion, it takes off their entrance gear. I think it even does it for Goldberg as well. Not Goldberg, Goldust. And his entire entrance is just his, him taking off his gear. So it kind of ruins the whole thing. The Booker Man, yo. Did anybody have the WWE original CD? Because I remember getting that like Easter 2004, I think. And I vividly remember like playing Simpsons Hit and Run, listening, because this is what I used to do. I used to listen to CDs. That's how old we are. I used to listen to CDs while playing games on the PlayStation 2. And I think I got like Simpsons Hit and Run and the WWE Originals CD. I just remember listening to it over and over and over again. Because that's what you did. You just didn't have a lot of stuff, so you just listened to stuff on repeat all the time.
Yeah.
Yeah, I remember just playing the Simpsons Hit and Run and listening to Stone Cold beat up Jim Johnson and some pretty mixed songs. But I always remember Booker's terrible song that he did. I mean, he did his best. It's better than I would have done. What about the superplex? What a job sesh. But yeah, he did his Can You Dig It. And that actually became his entrance music, and which was okay, but it got really bad when they tried to do a bad combination with... What? They did a bad combination with Booker T and RVD, WrestleMania 20. Go watch that and listen to it. What's going on here? Oh. I don't want to do that yet. I just stood there with the mic after the match. Woo! Ladies and gentlemen, the Raw franchise is prepared to sign the free agent Stone Cold Steve Austin. And here comes Vince. Ah. Love this. I'll tell you something, he wants an owner with leadership and management skills. Ah. My Vince is bad. Stone Cold Steve. Oh, God, it immediately left me. He'll sign a contract exclusively to SmackDown. What? The only thing I can do decently is Austin. I say decently, you probably don't. Say it's terrible. I say no to him and yes to you, huh? What? You want me to sign you a little contract? Okay, it's going bad already. It's immediately bad. We're not. We're done. You too, huh? I was interested in both, and I thought a lot about it. Thought about it a lot. I've made up my mind. The deal is done. We're just going to roll with it. Fuck it. He's going to sign this SmackDown. Vince, you know what? Today's April Fool's. What? Flair's so excited. He doesn't know what's coming. Don't trust the rattlesnake. DTA, don't trust Austin. Great, now Stone Cold's on Raw. Cool. And Big Show and Jericho beat Kane and RVD. So Jericho beats World Tag Champs. Future World Tag Champs. Ah, Booker T versus Rhino. Bubba Ray is going to face Albert. And then the main event is a six-man tag where Kane and the Hardys face The Undertaker. And the Un-Americans, how the hell would that get booked? The American Badass and the Un-Americans are going to go again. Okay. Probably a great match, though. On SmackDown, what the fuck? A Hell in a Cell featuring Maven and Tajiri. A hardcore triple threat with Billy and Chuck and Billy Kidman. And a cage singles match. Escape, Pinfall, and Give Up are all available between Edge and Kurt. Jesus, they're dropping a Hell in the Cell week two. What'd they do last week? Tag a single. Okay, so Kurt and Edge are feuding. Rikishi, Brock, Rock, and Benoit. Okay, Jesus. SmackDown's really going all out. We just got a fucking normal match. Okay. Usually first month isn't super... Oh, there's gold dust. Usually first month isn't super involved in storylines. Kind of the way it is for most of these games. First month is just kind of... What a treat. Aren't we supposed to be the best tag team? Oh, yeah, that's right. I can't believe that we have to wrestle separately. Is this right? It's right. Yeah, I see. But I don't feel that way. Okay, cool. Good talk. Good talk. All right, anyway. I don't even think he was booked. What is he complaining about? I mean, he's probably on heat, so that's... Yeah. I mean, you can complain about being on heat, I suppose.
Can you dig it, sucker?
Oh, his first Rhino entrance. Get out of the way.
And the opponent from Detroit, Michigan, weighing 285 pounds, Rhino.
I should have moved Rhino to SmackDown. What was I thinking? But we know Rhino very well. Spear Team 6 and all that, if you watch the... Here Comes the Pain playthrough. Edge and Rhino. Ended the year. I think losing the tag champs to Big Show and A-Train. I think that's how that ended. We lost the tag team titles in a ladder match because I decided to play on Legend or SmackDown difficulty, whichever the difficult one was. I just remember it was just one epic match with Brock Lesnar. Alright, he's got a schoolboy. Or his repertoire. The book of me. I feel like this game too, I want to say I got this for Easter, but it might have been a Christmas gift. All the way back in like 2000. Yeah, it had to have been a Christmas gift back in 02. But I just remember playing this so much. Maybe it was 03. I can't remember. I like started actually watching wrestling in 02. Like one of the first... wrestling show, one of the first like SmackDowns I remember watching was the SmackDown where Rey Mysterio debuted, which was like July of 02. It's the night Edge faces Jericho in the cage, and I think the next week is like Benoit and Eddie versus The Rock and somebody else, I don't remember. And like the show ends, like these are like the images that are burned into my memory, is like Benoit has The Rock in the crossface while Brock Lesnar's there just kind of taunting him in advance of the SummerSlam match, which going into that I remember we had that summer, we didn't buy it because, you know, that wasn't something that we weren't going to spend money on. But my parents' TV picked up the signal in their bedroom. I don't remember how we found out, but somehow we found it out. And
can you dig it,
sucker? And so we listened to like the first match on the card, which was Eddie versus, or not Eddie, but Ray and Kurt Angle. So we listened to it with like a static TV because that's all that we could get. And I probably would have sat there and listened to it all night, but yeah, that was a no. Anyway, Taker's team wins, defeats Matt Hardy. Bubba beats Albert. We'll check on SmackDown a little bit. But yeah, that's kind of my like my infant memories of beginning to watch wrestling in 2002. All right, back at it against Rhino, this time in a tables match. Steve Austin gets his first Raw match as he goes against Chris Jericho. And the main event is a triple threat match, which we have to double, triple reinforce the ring for, as Big Show, Kane, and The Undertaker go after it in triple threat. It's a match that sounds like probably happened, but I don't think it ever did. And SmackDown still doing cage matches. Jesus Christ, this is like a GM mode. Oh shit. Undertaker doing double duty. He's in a last man standing match against Rikishi. And The Rock faces Benoit. Let's see who won last week. Tajiri wins the best Hell in a Cell match. Billy beats Billy Kidman. So I think Kidman has to lose it. His Kidman or something. We can't change that. And Kurt won the cage. Alright. Let's do it. Let's do a table match. This will be like a 30-second match.
We welcome you here live from WWE Raw. What's going to happen in this wild week in the WWE? We are broadcasting Raw live from Bloomsbury, New Jersey.
We're in New Jersey. Alright. Turn on the concourse and see if anybody's here. My hypothesis is that there's always one person spawned somewhere in the places that you can go. Because you can pretty much walk everywhere. I might do that during the pay-per-view if you don't have a match. I'll walk around to all the different places we can go. But I think there's like one person spawn no matter what. I think. I don't know for sure.
Can you dig it?
This week will be pretty quick. We're continuing the feud with Rhino, and it's in a tables match. So let's do it. He's going to come after me, so I got to try to... All right. I think those are on the ground. Let me see what Booker's diving move is. Oh gosh. I really gotta try and get champion before. Oh, it's a suicide dive. I really gotta get champion before the rumble, because I really don't want to do the rumble in this game. I really don't want to do the rumble in this game. Oh, let's see if we can get an inside out. Houston hangover, way too long. Kick to the back. Can we see? I hit the wrong button. I think up is the Houston hangover, but we just finished it with a diving elbow. Nice and easy match. But yeah, we'll walk around the whole map, I guess. And we'll see all the stuff. So Austin wins his first match on Raw. Kane wins the triple threat, but he beats the Big Show, so Taker's protected. Week four. Are we going to face Rhino again? What do we got? Holy shit. We're in the main event. It's Big Show and Jericho. At least it's a tag. It's a one-on-two tag. So we're okay there. I'm going to try not to move my arm because it wants to fall on. First match is Bubba Ray and Albert in a hardcore match. Second match is a tornado tag between the Hardys and the Un-Americans. And then, yeah, I am in the main against Big Show and Jericho. They're really running roughshod through Raw right now. On SmackDown, Jesus, they got big guns here. Mark Henry and Devon, Rikishi and Undertaker continue their feud, and then Rock versus Brock with Vince as special guest ref. And oh, Taker beat Rikishi, Billy and Chuck beat Al Snow and Maven, and The Rock beat Benoit. All right, let's do this week's Raw.
We welcome you here live from WWE Raw. 18,403 on hand live tonight. Welcome to SmackDown. I'm Jim Ross, your host at ringside, along with Jerry the King Law.
What the fuck? JR, wake the fuck up. It's Monday, not Tuesday. Oh shit, we actually have to do the tag. Fuck. Alright, let's run around and see who's here. Goldust is here again. Oh, sorry, bud. Sorry, bud. Alright, heavy breathing. Alright, settle down. It's been out of the game for a while. You were here like 2 weeks ago. I've been waiting for the right time, keeping a low profile, waiting to make the biggest comeback ever witnessed. For my time has come to become the brightest star in the WWE. As bright as my star may be, there is one star that is brighter, and that star is calling out to me in the night, eagerly awaiting my response. When you wish upon a star, your dream comes true. My dreams will be realized, and they will not be shattered again. He knows this to be true. And when the curtain is lowered and the credits roll, he will remember the passion. And above all, he will remember the name. Goldust. Cool. I don't know what the fuck he was talking about, because he was literally here 2 weeks ago and was like, why aren't we partners? Oh, there's Lance Storm. What the fuck? What's up, Lance? You want to be serious for a moment? Oh, the hot coffee! Hey, Lance. Oh, what the hell are you doing? You missed your mouth there, bud. You teach me some respect. Right now. Hello. See, this is what I want out of the WWE games. I want them to do these stupid little... these little mini match. This is what I want. This is all I want out of a WWE game. And we haven't gotten anything like this since this game. Because, like... I don't know that I'm necessarily asking for, like...
that's smart, is what it is.
The same kind of freedom we get in this one. I don't know if I'm asking for that necessarily. Well, let's actually start to explore. So that's the arena. That's just you going through the stage instead of... I don't think I have my camera there. I don't know where I put the camera. I don't think it's going to work right there, because I think it's just going to block him when I get too far away. Oh, this is always fun. Bring it!
Lance doesn't have much personality, but he can wrestle.
Give me that. Oh, big chop. Yeah, this is what I want. I want them to have a season mode where they use storylines. Let's go into the locker room. Come on, just come a little bit further. There we go. Yeah, I want them just to use storylines that are happened in the freaking TV show and in history. So I want them to have a hot coffee. A hot coffee thing. Even if it's like this, where it's just a one-off match. Kendo stick. Yeah, even just a one-off backstage brawl. Oh, let's throw him into the TV. VCR with all those tapes.
Lance Storm, in my opinion, is one of the most underrated superstars in the WWE.
Oh no, my tape!
I don't like that. Suplex.
The VCR. Did they actually put the components on that? They did. Wow, that's pretty impressive. I know, it's just, actually, it's just a JPEG. I don't know why I'm being impressed by that. Let's put it in the locker. Can I do the thing? Yeah! Come here, Lance. There we go. Hit detection is. Damn it. That didn't work very well. It worked like 1 out of 4 times. Out of here. Let's go look at somewhere else. Go to the GM room. It's right next to us. A little bit further down the way. Come on, Lance. Miss that. Miss that. All right, go on. Oh, you son of a bitch. Oh. Here we go. Let's put him down with a bookend right here on the coffee table. On it.
It's coming. Oh.
There we go. Count it, Earl. Sorry about the clothesline. My bad. You saved me from a chair shot, though. So thanks, pal. But yeah, those are two of the places you can go. All right, let's get into this week where we have a hell of a match. Bubba Ray continues his win streak. Oh, whoops. You're welcome, Jeff. Didn't realize Lance had a match. He's probably going to be mad about that, but we'll never talk to him again. Big Show and Jericho. Jericho, bye-bye. Yeah, that doesn't matter.
Can you dig it, sucker?
The following contest is scheduled for one ball.
I gotta try and find a better solution for that. We'll give Jericho and Big Show their entrances. Alright. Alright. Yeah, I there is something in my brain. It completely just got snapped out of it.
What a team.
But yeah.
Close line.
Oh shit. Can I hear Jericho? I forgot to turn on the oh fuck. Or I'll do something. They're gonna beat me. You get knees and a big scoop. I don't know if he'll take the oh shit, that's right. Jericho's a, so the two of the biggest pains in the ass in this game are alright, since he has that. I got distracted by my own distraction. But two of the biggest pain in the asses to fight in this game are Kurt Angle and Chris Benoit, because they have such high... oh, fuck. Big show. But, because they have high technique. I think Jericho actually might have high as well. I actually didn't do the what I wanted to do. I wanted to do this.
Wake up and smell the coffee.
Whoa! There we go. Sure. Bookend. Close. One count? God, bury my finish, bud. Come here. Double team. Oh. But yeah, I'm glad we're on Raw because we don't have to worry about Angle on Raw. Angle is easily the hardest person to fight in this game. Okay, so Houston Hangover is... Or the Harlem Hangover. So I know it is. Get my dick. This is gonna be tough. Oh god, what's the button? Get him to submit. Oh, jackknife.
No, I can't believe it. There's the kick out.
That jackknife cover reminds me of like a story from wrestling school. It's very quick. We were, I think, a couple guys, it's not my story, but it was a story that was passed around. So there was a guy who we were training with who, I don't remember what, I think we were calling a match. Or they were calling a match and they were trying to like plan out spots and stuff. And they asked the guy, oh, like, can you do a jackknife? Like jackknife cover. And he looked at him straight up and just went, I don't do power bombs. Sorry, that's, I don't know. I don't know if it needed that much of a buildup, but it was a, it's a really funny, it was really funny at the time. We all really got a kick out of it. We kind of use that. Jesus. We kind of mention that anytime we talked about doing the jackknife. So. Oh, on the foot. It is a funny haha story. Another one. That might be the easiest way to take care of that. Let's go. Time for Backlash. I gotta update some shut-ins. Gotta check some stuff. We're not booked. This is bullshit. First match is a fatal four-way for the Cruiserweight title. It doesn't say it, but it will be. The Hurricane and Billy Kidman. The Hurricane is defending against Kidman, Guerrero, Tajiri. Lance Storm and Christian defending the tag titles against Al Snow and Maven. And RVD defends the Intercontinental title against Brock Lesnar in a ladder match. Oh, Lance Storm and Christian's a TLC match. Let's see what happened on SmackDown last week. Oh, that wasn't what happened. Anyway, whatever. All right. All right, let's kind of explore here a little bit. I'll just kind of show around the arena and everything. So we've been in the GM room. There is the locker room. GM room is right there. Or it's VIP, but that's where the GM is. So we can go talk to Flair. That's shop zone, so we can check out the things we can unlock. We're actually not going to get anything for this. Usually you unlock things by competing in a match or satisfying whatever condition there is. So this is... I don't even know what this is. But this is kind of a hub that leads us into... that goes back to the concourse. So we have the stock room, which is there. Boiler. And then that's the parking lot. So we'll do the parking lot last because that leads us outside. Boiler room, there isn't much to it. All right, that's the boiler room. Yeah, there's not much to it. Doesn't really lead us anywhere or do anything like that, so. Oh wait, that wasn't the boiler room. That was the stock room. Go to the boiler room. This one's actually fun to play in because you have this big spot there. And then there's, where is it? There's that, which I kind of want to, I'll have to find the trailer for the game, the commercial, because there's a, that's where the boiler room always reminds me of. There's a spot in the commercial where Brock throws like Rhino into like that red pipe. He has five people and onto this and There's dumpsters around the back of the box. And this leads us outside. And then we're going to go... we'll be outside the arena. And then we'll go into... Oh, to this... Okay, yeah, we're outside. So... I actually didn't look at them. So the SmackDown Bank. We're in New York, so we're at MSG. I guess that's what that is. The SmackDown Arena. SmackDown Arena. Okay. Hotel SmackDown Hotel. Actually really cool. And then right next to it is the train station. Just says station. I think if you stand out here, cars will just drive up. No cars driving. Alright, cool. So we'll take the train real quick and then we'll run all the way back and just skip through the show. And get to the first week of stuff. So here's the train station. And this is all stuff we can fight to. You know, first person New York City experience here. Great train here. It's crazy the stuff they did back then. Okay, I was gonna say when that door's gonna close. We're not even in there. There's no Booker T. We'll do this twice. Because there's not much over here. So there is the world. WWF feeding, or WWE feeding mankind since 1999. That's fantastic. There's the police department. This is like Times Square. Yeah, Times Square. God, they even got road signs and everything. This is really cool. I did all this so long ago, though. Yeah, back when the world existed. We haven't seen anybody, so maybe my theory is wrong. We're on stage here at the world. This is a restaurant. You can see the bar back there. Cool. All right. I think that's supposed to be like the Tough Enough trophy. All right. Cool. All right. So that's kind of all of the areas we can go to backstage. It was a fun little... I think that's actually what Times Square looks like, dude. Or it looked like, I should say. So if you didn't know, everything takes place in New York. Kiel Stadium. Thankfully, there's a very easy way to get back to the main stuff. That gets you back to the parking lot. All right, let's get through this week. Who's gonna be the next cruiserweight champion? Eddie Guerrero. Nice. Do we have new tag champs? Nope. No new tag champs. A new Intercontinental champ? Yes, we do. Brock Lesnar wins his only Intercontinental title. And that's the show. Hopefully we had a good time. Let's see what is in store for us this time. Tag match. Booker T and Goldust versus Chris Jericho and Lance Storm. Van Damme and DDP versus Albert and Raven. And Kane versus Big Show. King of the Ring next month. I think we'll get through King of the Ring and then we'll stop. So things should go a little bit quicker. We should be able to get through a little bit quicker. Oh, we're gonna do this whole tag story? I guess. It's fun. Hey, Booker and Goldust. Someone gave us the wrong directions. Goldust was driving. Oh, do we want to do Insurrection? Sure, we'll go do Insurrection. I wonder if... So normally when we do that, we face Regal. If we're babyface, we face Regal for the European title. If we're a heel, we tag with Regal. And I don't remember what Booker is in this game.
Can you dig it, sucker?
We gotta watch two of them. Oh, let's watch this one. I forget they were a legit tag team in this game. We haven't seen Storms yet.
And the opponents, Lance Storm.
But we've seen Jericho's. Rude. We faced Storm, but we haven't. I also think too, tag matches in this game weren't as fun because once you tagged out, you were still your character. You couldn't just switch back and forth. Oh wait, was switching? Was it this? Was it select? No, it wasn't select. I don't remember how to... Let me try and figure that out. Okay, it was R2, I think? Or... Maybe it was just... So the sticks on this controller that I'm using are not very good. There's drift on one that I just haven't fixed because I don't feel like opening up the controller. I don't know if I have compressed air. I have a air machine, like a blowing machine that I use to clean out my computer, which I probably need to do that as well. So I don't know if that would work for it. We're just gonna tag out the gold bus. And then we're just gonna attack Chris Jericho on the outside till we win. Because that's the easiest way to win matches. Alright, Goldust, you gotta turn around here, bud. Because I am beating the shit out of Jericho, and Storm is just about Dunsky here. Oh, big spine buster through the table. Let's go. Man, unless Storm goes for the win. He was pretty much done when I tagged out, so I don't know. Let's try and help out here. Come here. Oh.
Lance Storm is an idiot.
I'm just getting jerked up.
Power slam.
Don't want to do that. Goldust, how are you messing up here? Come on, man. Kick him in the gut, hit the curtain call, and let's go home. Oh, he's going to do the Shattered Dreams. Or he's not. I'm not going to cost our team the match. And, nope. Seriously. It's terrible. Get me in. Get me in. Get me in here. Alright. Do it, Chris. Try and win. All right, see if we can time this right. Yes. Pump handle. Oh, power slam. Come on. Come on.
That was a bad place to go for the pin. Lance, time to leave the office. Punch the back seat before you leave.
All right, well. Yeah. Hold us, get out. Come on. All right. We finished her off. We can do it, man. I think this is the storyline where, like, we do a breakup immediately. I don't think it is. Together through it all. Damn, I have 10. But none of it is. Interesting. Insurrection time. All right, so we're going to fight Regal for the title. Nice little Regal promo here. It feels great to be back in my home country, eh? except the fact that I have to see all your disgusting faces, eh? So I found out today that there is someone foolish enough to challenge me. I do accept your challenge, Booker. Hi, what's up? Oh, hello.
He's got that sadistic
I'm really
smile.
Looking forward to tonight's match. I don't know what that accent is, but it's not English. I'm a little reluctant to contaminate this sacred land with your sweat and tears, but I will be honored to provide victory for Her Royal Highness. You know what? We're going to make that happen, Regal. Sorry, the last time I looked at the score of the game, it was 14-14. Now it's 28-14 as Eddie defends his Cruiserweight title in a ladder match against Rico. Eddie retains. What the hell did I miss?
Can you dig it?
The following contest is scheduled for...
Sorry.
From WWE European Championship.
How is it? How did they score two touchdowns immediately? What the frick just happened? Oh, they scored 25 points in the second quarter? Oh, so it was two pick sixes. Okay, I didn't realize that. Shit. All right, damn. I picked the Saints to win because Coach Pagano picked that, but Jesus. I would assume people aren't going to complain about the Thursday night football game this week.
William Regal.
Jesus. All right. What you got? All right, shoulder tackle after a standoff. So I wanted to beat Rhino with the Houston Hangover through a table. Don't know if I can do the grapple. I think if I grapple him,
tonight is going to be
just.
Just
far enough away. Alright, well, superplex. Sorry, Earl. God damn it. Oh, this is perfect. Trying to see, I don't know if this will actually work or not. I don't think it does. I think I need to grapple him, which is gonna.
William Regal will take
I didn't think I could do that.
To win a match.
Okay, now I have to figure out other DQs. Or did that just not count because I grappled it?
He looks very
it's no DQ. Great. I wanted to lose this match. There's no count out, no DQ. God damn it. Because I think if I grapple him, that should be a DQ, right? Like, I can punch him. Call it, Earl. Alright, well. Let's see what he goes for here. To throw the match. But I guess I'm just gonna win it. Fuck it. Fans got to see what they wanted. Alright, we'll just win the match. Screw it. He kicks out. Oh man.
Can you dig it, sucker?
Oh, this is a dude. I didn't realize he had his own special one.
Can you dig it, sucker?
Nice. Cool. So now we're European champion. And we're gonna take the Insurrection Arena. I don't know why, but I always pick that. All right, and back to the back to this. I didn't even I just saw my match. Which we're facing Big Show and someone else. Yeah, it was a huge success. I'm the European champion. It's great. It's great. Oh, what's up, Flair? All set to have a great match at the next pay-per-view. It's going to be a tornado tag match. All right, cool. Showcase those abilities and represent my brand. My brand. Stuff. Oh, cage match. Jeff Hardy versus Planet Stadiac. Jeff won. Sorry, is that Big Show and Taz? Damn, why do you keep booking us against the Big Show, man? Oh yeah, I should have moved Big Show to SmackDown too. I moved Regal over and he didn't even belong there, and I forgot about Rhino and Big Show. Look at that. Booker T Goldust. I don't think we're gonna get a good view of the tag of the belt for a while. We haven't seen Taz yet, so let me go away for that. I actually kind of prefer in a way. I'm gonna really need those indicators. Oh shit. See, Taz, if I wanted to do the Rumble, Taz would be a really fun one to play with, because his that belly to belly that he just hit me with, you can send someone over the top of that. then Big Show has the catapult, which that's a good one to send somebody away with. Hold us. Idiot. Way too late for that. Spine on the pound. Trying to get Goldust to like grapple Big Show so I could go for a cover there. He's just focused on Taz, man. Oh, damn it. Oh, tap. Become just another victim. Brother. Sweet. Nice! Cheeky little schoolboy there, man.
Can you dig it, sucker?
You had to carry the match. It's your fault.
It's a severe separation. Neither of them.
Ridiculous. All right, we're facing Big Show for the third straight week, I think. It was first week just Lance Storm and Jericho. All right, cool. Let's get it going. Sorry, I just learned of this neck hump thing, and now I'm just like looking up stuff about it because I have it severely. I'm like, oh, I didn't realize that that was a thing. And I have it really badly. Oh shit, we're gonna get a little Divas contest. Not even bikini contest. All right, cheer for him. Who's your favorite? Is it Trish? Big Popski, eh? All right, you love your job, this is great. He doesn't pick anybody. He's just like, all right. Uh-oh. Goldust? Who's he talking to? Lance Storm isn't even in the match. What the hell were you talking to him? What? The audacity of this man. All right, Tornado, six-man tag, Bradshaw and the Hardys versus a fucking clusterfuck of a tag team. Stasiak, Albert, and Christian. Taker versus Austin, which is the semi-main. Austin wins. Booker T and Goldust versus Big Show and Lance Storm. Was he always in the match? Did I just not read that right? And he was always in the match?
Can you dig it, sucker?
Following tag team contest is scheduled for one ball. On the way to the ring, Booker T.
Can you dig it, sucker?
And the partner, Goldust.
What's that? Oh, wow. I've been visited. Yeah, apparently there's this thing called Ballinger's Hump, which is like occurs on your neck, like at the base of your neck in the back. So I've noticed it all the time, but I just never knew what it was or what it meant. I just thought it was, I don't know, because I was real fat. But apparently it's a thing. So I gotta find some exercises to get rid of it. I'll let you know next week what we figure out. Because I'd always notice it when I was squatting, when I put the bar on my back. Never knew that existed. And I've been to like doctors before. No one said anything about it. Get out of here, Lance. Oh, let's go. Oh, Goldust, get out of the way. Earl, do you want to do something about them? Oh, shit. This is what this has turned into. Come on, Earl. Sometime today. I'm worrying about the wrong guy. Been wearing this hat all day, so.
The Big Show is tossing around the challenger.
I think since we started late today, probably end a little bit early for this first episode of many. Hopefully not many, but I'm just kind of tired right now. I'd like to ideally start these around 7, but I don't think I started until like 5 much later. I started at almost like 8 o'clock. So. Oh, normally I can time that. Or you can just counter him.
Lance Storm, in my view, is one of the most underrated shits coming in the WWE.
God damn it. He never gets that way. Pin him. Oh, Boston Crab. Just gonna beat on the Big Show out here. Let's see if I can get him out on the barricade. I'll stay up. As I'm doing the spinneroonie. Here, take this. Oh, hell no. Be cool. Pin him. Come on, Goldie. Pin him. Curtain call. There you go. Look. Big Show's not getting this match. The longest freaking move in history. You moron. Get him out of the ropes. Tag me up. This is what you were working on with Storm. There we go. Let's see the cutscene that shows that didn't just happen. Oh, it just seeds of deceit and. Dissentment? I don't think that's a word. Deceit, though. Oh, we got one more week. Oh, that's right, because Insurrection added a week to our program. Hardcore tornado tag. Cool. All right. Let's do it to it.
We welcome you here live for WWE Raw.
That's it. Short intro from JR. Let's just get to it. I'm getting tired. It'll be short tonight. We'll kind of finish out this story, and then we'll end just before King of the Ring. Oh crap, I forgot. Hardcore matches just start. There are no entrances. Come on, Chris. Missed twice.
Check this out.
All right, so the plan is just... Oh, God damn it, why'd you kick him out, Goldust? Come on, man. All right, well, let's go to the stage then. Shit, how they're coming. Go up that way. Oh! Right on the stage. I love the stage in this game because the sound effects are so good. I swear if he just took the fall there, man. Goldust knocked him out again. But he's not getting out of the ring. So that's at least good for us.
He ain't no sucker tonight.
Getting close here. Bookend on the stage is the finish. Lance Storm, get the fuck away from me. It's a hardcore match, and they have to be right up our ass. Goldust, you have one job. This is the finish. On the ramp. Oh, he got the double cover. Oh, man. Oh. Where's he going? Booker just an absolute unit. Look at him. Oh, fucking hell. Jesus. 2-on-1. Goldust just left Booker. This tag team has evidently broken up. Evidently? Is that right? Anywho, Steve Austin wins the Battle Royal. All right, going into the pay-per-view, I believe it's Judgment Day. Yes. And why are we in a tag against them? There's no way that's the title match. No way Christian versus Undertaker is the title match. Ow. What is this card? Bradshaw defends the hardcore title in a six-man time limit match. Me and Goldust apparently we're cool. We're booked in the tornado tag match against Christian and Storm. Chris Jericho and Storm. But speaking of Christian, he's facing the Undertaker. Is that for the title? I don't know. I love that match and I want him to win. Oh, we get fireworks. We're not at SmackDown, JR. It's the pay-per-view. God, man. JR just wants to be at SmackDown. All right, here. Let's get through it. Oh, no, we got to talk to the Hurricane. Good old Shane Helms. Hey, do you have any problems? I'm kind of good. Yeah, I'm okay. Well, I do, but those aren't problems that I have. Oh, this one's like having some powers. That's what every citizen wants to know. It's not easy being a superhero. I have to battle evil everywhere I go. It's hard work. All right, cool. So it kind of sucks what he said, basically. All right, so this is for the hardcore title. Who's going to... Regal, you can get a title back. Regal does win! I was covering it, but Regal won. All right, a fucking nothing tag match that apparently is still happening, even though I got jumped and Goldust did do a fucking thing. Cool.
Can you dig it, sucker?
But this Judgment Day set, infamous for the Hogan versus Undertaker match for the WWE title, where Hogan got up for the shittiest choke slam I've ever seen in my entire life. And I have seen very, very unskilled people deliver a choke slam. Is Goldust going after me? Fuck. But yeah, Hogan had that. He fucking absolutely was a bag of shit for Undertaker on that choke slam. He didn't get. He went parallel almost immediately. Like, Hogan took that choke slam as like a back bump. You know, normally for a choke slam, you're supposed to like use the arm here. You're supposed to like post on his shoulder and then jump to get like a lot of height. Some guys will even like, you'll see, I think Orton does it, where he'll like put his arm on like the shoulder and then jump and extend and just push off so he's really, really high up. Fucking Hogan just went, just immediate just back bump. I think it was like a slight jump. I don't know if like his knees were shit, so he didn't want to do, see, here's the thing. If he didn't want to do the spot, like if he wasn't physically able to do the spot, like, oh, my knees were shit or something, then just don't fucking do it. Do a different spot. It's the Undertaker. He can win 17 different ways. It's fine. There we go. Like, it's the Undertaker. He can win 17 different ways. I guess he didn't want to take the tombstone. He wasn't going to take a last ride, so I guess chokeslam, sure. All right, are we going to... What are we gonna have? What's gonna happen here? I won the match. Is he gonna betray his partner like that? What's he gonna do? A farewell shot. What an impact, physically and mentally. Booker and Goldust are definitely separated. All right, well, that's the end of that story. So now we're gonna go next time into King of, oh my God, it was for the title. That was for the title. Holy shit. But why can Christian win? God dang it. You can actually interfere in those matches if you're not booked. Damn it. Sucks. All right. But that's where I'm going to leave it for this one. And I'm going to try and continue to talk. I'm not going to. It's not going to work. So this is gonna, that, yeah. All right. That's where we're gonna leave it tonight. Next week we will pick up with the King of the Ring, and hopefully I get started sooner so we can actually do more. Because right about now I get tired. So if we can get started closer to 7 o'clock, by now we'd be at like 2.5 hours. And I think each month will take about a half an hour, give or take, depending on the matches and depending on different stuff, basically. But yeah, I can't back out anymore. I don't want that video to cause copyright. So yeah, I am just gonna, you know what, let's just do a com versus com match. And I will see you guys next time. All right. See, all right, sure. Go ahead and check out Jericho versus Stephanie McMahon. And I'll see you next week. Okay, bye. We'll be right back.